lightly any longer. Malanga, you feel that's a serious issue?
For me, talking tough by Mr. President
is not new.
It's not new to me. That phrase is not new. We see that all the time, and nothing has happened over time. Yeah, he can talk tough. He's not today, he's been talking tough. But what has come as a result of the toughness of the talk? You know, we want action. It's not about talking. Sometimes Mr. President just want to talk. And again, my challenge with Mr. President, sometimes when he talk, I don't really know whether I think I will still blame his advisors. Some of this thing is not just about talking tough. There are some approaches that should have, been considered that has not been considered. Since all the sessionists and all that, people want to, there is no crime in saying, I want to go.
Exactly.
So when you are saying you will do this, you will do that, there is no crime in any region saying, I want to go.
Are you saying that is not a crime?
It is not a crime to say I want to go. It's not written anywhere.
Okay.
In our constitution.
Okay.
Now, then, what Mr. President should have done, or his advisor, should have, told him is, let us have a dialogue.
But now, he cannot tell me he doesn't have time.
My brother,
he cannot say he doesn't have time because Mr. Ngige just came out to say Mr. President is ready to dialogue. Whether that also is just a way to just, is also a false declaration or something like that to the people to make people feel okay, we are interested. See, I'm saying if people are okay, something just happened. You created four universities.
Yes.
For me, there's no
need for those universities.
The one we have. Thank you. How well are they equipped? The ones we have,
the ones struggling.
We are not paying salary of lecturers. We don't have equipment in the school, in university. When a university graduate come out, you cannot see anything, any result from a university graduate. What are the equipment? I told you one of the program or a number of, whether it's this platform or another platform, when a whole school is being given 150 million. And I asked to do what? A whole university. And this is one of the biggest universities when it comes to, and I asked, what do they want to do? Not even research. We have not talked about research. We have not talked about the medical school of that particular university. We have not talked, we have not talked about a department. And yet you just want to create, and not, that is not even the angle I'm considering about creating schools. Now you are creating four universities. None. None of the four has gone to the southeast, and you want them to say everything is where?
Okay, you created four universities. No. Where?
My Thank brother, you. Where?
Let me
in the north.
Let me take east. A climb on your back.
Yeah.
I don't know why people cannot get these things right. The people are chasing to go is a reaction to some situations. And what are they reacting to?
I thought it was just about the idea.
No, you see, they didn't just wake up and
say they want to go.
No,
the reaction.
There were precedents that led to that. And I will give you one, a few. Number one, the lopsided appointments that we have witnessed in the last 6 years, in my over 6 decades as a Nigerian, has never happened. We've been shouting, we've been complaining. It's like we're knocking on a concrete wall. Number two, when you look around, it is so obvious that some people are pampered while others are treated as if they are second-class citizens. In Nigeria, I'm not saying what you don't know. We can go on and on. And then people now felt, look, if you are my father in a family and you are treating my brother and sister differently from how you are treating me, come on. I have the right to denounce you and take a walk. Okay? Now, instead of addressing those critical issues, you are now talking tough. Who does talking tough help?
You are saying you are talking tough terms are with illegal arms bearers. that you see that Gumi will go and Gumi will go and have meetings with and they'll be brandishing weapons, AK-47 and all those armories. They'll be brandishing them and nobody
they take pictures
and nobody has arrested them.
Video.
Nobody has done anything. Then you've been talking tough since 1900. Now we are still here. You are still talking tough. And nobody has been arraigned in whatsoever among these people that you know. Even if you claim you don't
because
know.
Because they have our children.
Even you, if you claim
they
you don't
the
know.
They have the children they kidnap.
The so-called mediator. The so-called mediator. Even if you as a government says you don't know.
He's been able to know.
But the so-called mediator knows these
he
people.
He knows where they are.
And he said he mediate between the government and this militant. And you see weapons with them. Let and you are talking tough.
Let me amaze you.
Who is deceiving who?
Let me amaze you. Since the president said they should shoot aside anyone found with AK-47, how many have been shot aside?
I've even said that statement, that statement was
no,
even
no,
out
no,
of place.
No,
and he still
two.
Emphasized on it, still repeated the statement.
Number two, Gumi has the temerity to tell us that there are over 100,000 bandits in the forest. So he has taken a census and has a figure. The same him came out and said we should hire bandits to secure schools. When it was these same bandits that brought about the insecurity in the schools. Why do we have to continue hugging our problems, deceiving ourselves, pretending as if we will wish those things away? I don't read papers anymore. I don't listen to radio and TV anymore. Because what they will get to hear will dampen your spirit and make you feel so bad. And before you know, one may slide into depression. We don't deserve all of these things we are getting. Nigerians deserve more. And we're not asking for too much. Only the irreducible minimum that will make life meaningful. Now, I told you before that we are in famine already. Why? Farmers across the nation cannot go to their farms. As simple as ABC, to go and work and then produce food for the nation. Here we are, as they said, our national reserve is so low that if care is not taken, we will have problems financing our import. And we are importing food. And why are we,
I've told you that we are not importing food. Yesterday, Osun State government cleared hectares, over 1,000 hectares of land to plant.
What was it cleared yesterday? And then tomorrow they will harvest. Let me tell you, we are playing with fire. Somebody said we are sitting on a clay of gunpowder. And I said we are sitting on a burning gunpowder already.
We're not sitting on a keg of gunpowder, in your opinion. Anyway, we're still taking a look at some of these stories, and the president is apparently talking tough. You may not want to agree, but the communique of the conference proposed the engagement of no fewer than 10,000 youth members of the APC in critical positions in 2023. The APC youths are seeking 10,000 appointments.
You see, I think there's a misplaced priorities.
No, but young people want to be in power.
You don't understand. I am with young people to take over.
Okay.
And I've been asking for this for a long time. It is time. The people, the crop of people that we have in power today started as young people. They started in their 20s, in their 30s. They are still here today in their 70s, 80s, 90s. Still running the affairs of the country.
Nice.
Yes. Now, it is not you seeking. They did not seek in their time. Yes. They stood up to the challenges. They took over. They were involved. They were not sitting and seeking appointments. That is the reason I'm saying is a misplaced priority. They are going the wrong way. We are saying, and what I am asking them to do, get involved in the politics of your country.
Right
the
now.
Social media will not take you anywhere in the politics of your country. Whatever you do on social media
what
is just not. They're
going to
look at it and laugh at you because it ends there.
Also, what did you say, Bishop Oyedepo, say the game about social media?
He said they are forfeiting their future
to social media.
On this university thing, before I forget. We don't need these four universities. We already have an army of graduates who have nothing to do. why don't they start thinking of industrialization, providing employment for the teeming unemployed people instead of bringing more universities? I mean, it's not about numbers of universities. No.
Let's move to another conversation. Twitter ban. The House of Representatives today begin the probe. And they've invited the Minister of Information and Culture, Alhaji Lai Mohammed. They've also invited the NGO and the CSOs to appear before them today. Just before, at the time we started this conversation this morning, we're talking about something very irresponsible that happened today. And it had to do with irresponsible blogging. I don't call such people journalists. Well, somebody decided to post the obituary of
Pastor Eske Abiara.
Prophet Eske Abiara yesterday and announced to the whole world that Prophet Eske Abiara is dead. Now, if I can pick a little bit of a comment from a son who was the one responding to all of the questions yesterday, but he mentioned something to me. He said, I'm not going to take this lightly with this woman, and I intend to fight it. We're going to the reps to defend this social media bill. First of all, as a lawyer, do we have the right to take these guys to court, especially the bloggers, when they post these irresponsible stories about us?
That is why you have to be responsible in your dealings. It has nothing to do with bloggers alone. This cut across everyone. Whatever you're doing, because your right stops where the other person's right starts from. So when you say because you have a right
to post anything on social media,
and then you bring a libel, whatever against me, I will take you to court.
Straight up.
All right. Then go and tell the court that you're a blogger. So you have every right to put up defamation or to defame my character and all that. So you see, we as a people have said that this can be checked. There should be a checkmate on this social media stuff. They should be able to manage it. That is what we are saying. We are not saying they should suspend or like you have said. Some of these bloggers, they don't know jack about. They are not even journalists. They don't know anything. They just spawn. They call themselves names and they put up all sorts lies or truth. They put up all sorts there.
Let's take that reaction from Pastor Isaac Abiara. Good morning.
How are you?
Very well, thank you. I need you to turn down the volume of your TV set.
Yeah, it's down. I don't know. Okay, go ahead.
Yes, it's down now. Although I can still hear myself.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you clearly now. When you got the news yesterday of Baba's apparent enemy's demise, what was your reaction?
Frankly, I was shocked. I mean that any journalist, blogger, or anyone will actually even say that. It's just beyond me, and it's absolutely number one, it's offensive, it's ridiculous. So if you are going, my take is, if you are going to write a story like that, any story, now to talk of someone's demise, first of all, at least you need to get information from a family member, from, you know, and when I saw that, I was like, no, this. So normally before, you know, Tommy, you know Papa very well.
Yes.
He's a man of peace. Whenever things like this happened before, he would say, you know, don't leave them alone. They don't know what you're doing.
He told us today that we should forgive her as well.
That we should even pray for her.
That we should pray for her for forgiveness.
Yeah. So this one, I didn't even tell him I was going to take it up with the blogger. You know, her name is I think Kemi Ashefon or something like that. So because I know if I told Papa that, Papa, I'm going to respond to this, he would say leave her alone. You know, she doesn't know what she's doing.
But let me measure, Pastor. Let me measure here. That singular moment of posting that story, what did it do to your family yesterday?
Oh, it put us through stress. My siblings in the U.S., they were calling, you know, Bishop, what's going on? What's going on? We're hearing this. To make matters worse, at that time, Abba was resting. So it was sleeping. So everybody was calling. So they were trying to get somebody. So it really threw the whole family into panic.
Can you imagine?
You know, but now, me being in Nigeria, I just spoke to him maybe
Not funny at all.
You see, I'm just wondering, and now the House of Representatives is probing this today and comes back to the lawyer in the studio this morning. Olayinka, this is one reason why a lot of Nigerians will be for this bill. You know that, right?
See,
well, how do we achieve a balance?
This bill is already there. What we are saying is we had a challenge with the PID bill.
Yes.
And because they were just doing back and forth on it and all that, if that has been passed, if all that had been put in place, we will not be talking about this because those checkmates are there. It's not just Baba. Recently, one just carried Tinubu's Tinubu died. Thank God the man came back from France. I mean, so all these things need to be checked. So if you are doing that, then you should be able to pay the price. So if you employ that, yes,
pay the price.
You must pay the price. Yeah, if you don't have, where do you get your sources from? Where are your sources from? Like he said, you didn't reach out to any of the family members. You don't know, and the next thing is for you to go because you want to be popular. I don't understand. So all this thing to be checked. That's the reason why we are saying all these bloggers, not people just expressing their, but these are influencers. They are influencers. So if you have a responsibility, then it must be responsible. So if you are not responsible, then you must pay the price.
Bishop, we need to let you go. I want to say thank you so much for joining us this morning.
I just needed to measure
what this did to your family yesterday. Ari, how do you close? He said they must be responsible. If you're not responsible, you pay for it. 30 seconds.
If you must do the crime, for me, it's a criminal act. You must be able to do the time. It's not enough to pay fine. They should go to jail.
By the
time 2, 3, 4 people are sent to jail for publishing
fake news,
false and fake, and so that never happened. And then they are taught that lesson. Others will either sit up or ship out. We cannot have a nation where, like I said earlier on,
fake news
with your $2 Chinese device.
You are causing trouble. I need to go this morning. Thank you so much.
Imagine the whole family members of the church all over the world thrown into disarray because of one person's irresponsibility. It should not be allowed.
Are, thank you so much for being here with us this morning.
My pleasure.
Our guests this morning, Are Oladende, Areyo, and of course, Olayinka Oladaniels. You see them again on the Bumper Breakfast. My name is Tomisi Ojo. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you tomorrow.
I mean, you don't have to damage people.
To verified sources for their news today, they just go straight to the pages of social media.